Welcome back. You're watching Mirror Now. We're looking at the exit polls. It's fascinating, really. But where we are right now, the exit polls are giving the BJP and their allies, so the NDA altogether, 306 votes, which comfortably takes them past the halfway mark safely to form the government. A referendum really to the leadership of Narendra Modi, who has been given a 2 thumbs up, a 5-star rating, and a second term if this is how the final results are going to turn out. Now, we looked at the South and, of course, the West, but let's also look at the interesting states in the North, which is Delhi, Punjab and Haryana. Delhi, of course, was a super sluggish fight for all of this, all of the parties involved, the Aam Aadmi Party, the Congress and the BJP. It was a triangular fight. It'd be very interesting to see how that fight might have turned out because of the exit polls. Statutory warning, this is an exit poll, not the final result. The final result will be on Thursday, the 23rd. But Tanvi's standing by with the exit poll breakup of Punjab, Haryana and Delhi. Tanvi?
Thanks for that, Faye. Like you said, and Delhi is very interesting because, you know, in 2014, it was a clean sweep. All 7 constituencies went to BJP. State elections or Delhi elections after that gave a thumping majority to the Aam Aadmi Party. And now we are back to the central elections. So let's see what the figures show up for the national capital. Continues to remain in BJP's grip. 6 seats are projected to go to the BJP's bag and about 1 seat for the Congress Party. 0, nothing for the Aam Aadmi. So not much change for the Aam Aadmi Party from 2014. What will be interesting is to see this 1 seat that has changed. And I'm going to ask our panelists to raise a wager and see if they want to take any guesses on which is that 1 seat that Congress is going to win in the national capital. Mm-hmm. But before that, very quickly, let's go across to Punjab and then show you Haryana, the other seats. And this is interesting. Captain is obviously leading the revival. And we're just going to come back to... here is the Congress seats. From 3, they have gone to 10. So that's the victory from Punjab that Captain Amrinder Singh seems to be delivering. It's very interesting because when it comes to Punjab, there's not too much of interference from the Congress central leadership, from the Gandhis. It's usually left to Captain Amrinder to get that. And as far as the BJP and its allies, Shiromani Akali Dal, is concerned, they're expected and projected to get 3 seats, half from what they got. And in that, I can tell you that 1 seat is actually just going to BJP and 2 are projected to go to Shiromani Akali Dal. Presumably, the Badals would end up winning that. So the loss here is the gain for the Congress Party. And this is also interesting because AAP seems to be finished in Punjab as well. Let's quickly get you Haryana and then you all can analyze these numbers. Here is what the Haryana table looks like. So we were discussing this and you had Rajiv Pandey commenting about it. And irrespective of what Emil Khattar may or may not have done, the vote clearly seems to be in the name of Narendra Modi. 8 seats, much better than what they got actually in 2014. 2 seats to the Congress Party, and that loss is coming from INLD. Back to you guys.
All right, Tanvi, thank you so much for for those numbers. Very interesting, of course, and the challenge is placed before the panel on Delhi to figure out which is that 1 seat that Congress has won in Delhi or Congress might have won in Delhi. But joining us on the show, T.R. Ramchandran, Ratan Malila, both senior journalists, and of course, E. Petty Reddy, who is with the TDP. So he joins us out of Hyderabad. So let me first go across to Mr. Reddy. Mr. Reddy, good evening. Have you looked at the numbers coming out for Telangana? Are you pleased, really? Or, there are a lot of the opposition members are saying, don't trust these numbers, it's all rubbish. Do you also think it's rubbish, or do you think that this is a good sign right now, that it's placing your party safely, what is your reaction to those numbers?
Yeah, good evening to everybody. Now we are discussing about the exit polls. So, overall my observation is, the people of the country, they are not rejecting openly. So they are endorsing popular governments one more time. Some of the states also is happening like that. Even the nationwide, if you see the exit polls, so it is looking like that. So the entire propaganda took place, anti-Modi or pro-Modi. Only two ways of discussion has taken place, either UPA or even regional parties. So finally, the people's mandate is the final one, but 23rd we can able to know what exactly the figure, but as per the surveys are concerned, some of the states, the BJP declined, and some of the states, they are not even having a single seat or one or two assembly segments they have earlier, but they are increased quite number in West Bengal and Orissa, in some other states. The Karnataka also they retained. Earlier it was 17, now it is showing a little bit more. So whereas Andhra Pradesh and Telangana, they may not got the number. As per this projection is, seeing the projections, both the states, they don't have.
Yes, but Mr. Reddy,
opened the account. Maybe they can open
the
account.
Mr. Reddy, according to our poll, according to the Times Now VMR poll, the YSRCP is getting 18 seats. That's an increase of 10 from its previous tally. And the TDP is losing 8. So from 15, you've gone down to 7. This is what we're looking at right now. Do you perhaps believe that Jagan Mohan Reddy might be a lot stronger this time than he was last time? Have you underestimated him perhaps?
No. Seeing the Telangana polls, the government has endorsed by the people. Even Andhra Pradesh also, it will be happened similar manner. But whereas the parliament is concerned, maybe it is a little bit different number is showing. But I won't feel that the Andhra Pradesh also, the popular government will be endorsed by the people. That's what I feel. The parliament is different and the assembly is different. For assembly, people are thinking the popular leader should be performed one term more into the Andhra Pradesh. But regarding the parliament comes, the UPA is not properly performed up to the mark. The regional parties, some understandings, alliances are not taken place properly. The people are confused. Only single propaganda was taken place, only anti-Modi. So, some extent, they have succeeded, but not up to the mark of the form of the government. What I feel,
so seeing Reddy, this... is it an anti-Modi vote in in Andhra Pradesh, or is it an anti-Naidu vote in Andhra Pradesh? Because you seem to have lost a lot to YSRCP.
Maybe, but anti-incumbency will be there in any popular governments. But Telugu Desam, they performed well. They performed well. The people are not that much hanger on the government. So, for the state purpose, they may endorse one more time. But parliament number may not be different to the assembly. We have to see. Some of the surveys are telling the TDP is going to get more seats in assembly and parliament. But some surveys are telling different. But there is no proper understanding. There is no single voice is not there in Andhra Pradesh.
Okay. All right, Mr. Reddy, thank you for joining us. Mr. Ipedi Reddy is the spokesperson of the TDP. Of course, worrying results on the exit poll for the TDP. It looks like it's losing out to YSRCP. That would mean that it loses clout, not just in the alliances that it was looking to form, but also in the state. Last question, Mr. Reddy, if you haven't mic'd out already. In terms of the alliances, we know that Mr. Naidu was having a lot of conversations in the run-up to these exit polls and perhaps in the run-up to the final results as well. How does this affect, and what is the status of his conversations right now? Is he going with the Congress party, or is he looking at a federal front or a third front, or is there a possibility of any such front given these numbers that we're looking at right now?
Actually, frankly speaking, we don't have any controversy with the BJP or Modi, except the special status of the Andhra Pradesh. only that, but only one issue. So always the my party will be with the people. Except that, nothing will be there. So they are openly told that is not going to happen. So they are taking a different stand. We are going to give the assurance, then we have to support to the other party. But Congress has given an assurance. So towards that, to get that status, he is working out, he is pulling the regional parties. To some extent, he want to make a popular government from NDA to UPA or other than UPA in third alliance. That we have to see. That total number will be 30-40 seats are difference are there. Not absolutely one side mandate is not there. So we can't say alone BJP how many seats they are going to get. With the NDA partner, how many seats they are going to get. The others, other than NDA, others,
okay,
the number may be increased. The Congress number also may be increased. But the number will be the same number. So there is no scope, there is no hope to form a other than NDA government. That what I observed seeing your surveys report.
Yes. All right, Mr. Reddy, thank you for that input. But I also want to bring to our panel's notice, Mamata Banerjee has thrashed the exit polls, saying that the game plan is to manipulate or replace EVMs through this gossip. And she has asked opposition parties to stay united, saying we will fight this fight together. A similar tweet has gone out from Derek O'Brien as well. There it is. She says opposition parties need to be united and we have to stand strong. Derek O'Brien, has the Delhi media, and he's put it in quotes, who masqueraded as national media, lost their credentials and credibility? So-called exit polls will only confuse. We wait for the verdict. Modiji called the number 300 plus even before phase 7. Are these numbers to match that? Or EVM manipulation? I mean, I find this suggestion of EVMs quite comical at this point, because this number has absolutely nothing to do with EVMs whatsoever.
Yes, and I think it's also, I don't understand why politicians can't raise their levels of maturity. Of course, exit polls are exit polls, they're not the truth. This is something likely to change on May 23rd, but to suggest that this is all part of a grand national conspiracy where every single news broadcaster has conspired with whoever and will quiet at the dead of a night in cloak and dagger go and replace EVMs is,
So, but I don't understand, how does that conspiracy lead to replacing EVMs?
No. What Derek O'Brien is suggesting is we are leading up to this.
We are helping this along.
So, okay.
The real work will be done by others,
But we are helping them.
He's really overthinking this.
Yes. So are we catalysts? It is funny if there is so much of unanimity among all media.
That's what, yes.
Then it is a wonderful thing.
No, actually there are a
couple. But I can promise you there is
different ones as well. I mean, look.
But near about the same.
Near about the same.
I think that's the important part. And, we've got some questions from our viewers saying, how reliable is this? How do we know? See, the difference here is that the various polls, and Vivek Kaul is with us. Vivek likes to crunch numbers. Vivek, everyone's polls and all of the polls that we have right now, do we have, let me just ask Swati if she has the poll of polls. Do you have a poll of polls that we can pop up on the screen? Not yet. All right, when we do have it. But Vivek, they're between 280 and 315 for the NDA. There's nobody who's starkly different. Is that a clue that perhaps these polls are on the right track? At least in general direction.
See, largely, I don't have a direct answer for this, but, if you look at the history of exit polls, they largely tend to get the direction right, even though they get the numbers wrong more often than not. But this comes with the rider that in 2004, of the 16 exit polls that were conducted, none of them got it right. So when they go wrong, they go horribly wrong. The other point that is interesting this time around, and it wasn't really there earlier, is the fact that in the last 5 years, many media houses, many TV channels which have commissioned these exit polls have essentially become the mouthpieces of the Modi government. So you need to discount for that as well, given the fact that I don't see any reason as to why, they will not continue to be mouthpieces at least until, May 23rd when the actual results come out. So I think, the way to look at it is to sort of discount the poll of poll by around 15-20% for the BJP, and that should roughly give you the right result.
Well, that's interesting, Puri. The fact that at the end of the day, and we have more of the opposition Captain Amrinder Singh has slammed the polls as well. He says, with his 50 years plus of experience in politics, this cannot be accurate. For 50 years, I've been watching. So this is not accurate.
But he's won.
Yes.
Yeah, he's exactly. The very same exit polls are showing that he's done remarkably well in Punjab.
Yes.
I hope he disses that as well.
That's the thing. He's won in
You
Punjab.
Can't be selective.
Yeah, you can't be selective. Because he's gained remarkably at the expense
of...
Let's also pop up the Delhi number. And let's quickly look at the Delhi number because we haven't discussed that yet. And here's the question I want to ask. Other than trying to guess which is the one seat, which one seat the Congress did win.
Is that Sheila Dikshit?
Could it be Sheila Dikshit? No, you don't think so.
I feel in Chandni Chowk is a small constituency and predominantly Muslim area.
No, I have a different view on this. I think it's probably New Delhi. Meenakshi Lekhi was not popular there at all. She was a bit on the... In fact, they were about to change her ticket. They didn't do it the last
time. But she went to court and asked for the apology from Raji.
That's right.
But let's look in Delhi at the Aam Aadmi Party. This is, of course, this would mean that the Aam Aadmi Party has lost all its seats, including Aatishi Madlena has lost.
They've lost. But they never, in 2014, when they were at their height, they got no seats.
No, but here's my question. Does this mean the Aam Aadmi Party is finished or can it continue to exist at the state level? I know that in politics, nobody's ever really ever finished, but from where it is right now.
Without no malice to Arvind Kejriwal and his team, basically, Aam Aadmi Party and Arvind Kejriwal, they are media boys. They are hyped by the media and not so much at the ground level. Except that in the 2014 elections, they won 67 out of 70 seats in assembly. So perhaps their strength is in assembly.
That's why I was about to say the same thing. Yeah. You should look at the Aam Aadmi Party in the same with the same pair of glasses that you look at some of the regional parties. I mean, for instance, the TRS. KCR is king in that area.
Yes.
So, Arvind Kejriwal might end up still being king of Delhi.
In fact, even in Punjab, where the last time they had one seat, this time the tally is zero.
Look, I have a slightly different take on the Aam Aadmi Party as well. Look, Delhi is a very unusual state. It's a state that has only seven seats but enjoys disproportionate number of eyeballs simply because the media is concentrated there. Yes. Ease of access makes coverage disproportionate for any party. It's not just this. When Sushma Swaraj was replaced and brought in as the Chief Minister for 2.5 months, she was being covered round the clock by the media.
Yes.
They chased her all over town. She went on raids to police stations at 2 a.m. She did all kinds of theatrics and it was covered as much. So yes, the Anna agitation did get carpet coverage and Kejriwal was clever enough to use it and turn it into a political advantage for himself. But having said that, I think the Aam Aadmi Party's losses because it's a party that one has fallen between two stools. It's a party that in my book has killed the concept of hope in this country because they came on the plank of changing the narrative of Indian politics. I think when you pitch it that high, the disappointment is equally quick because people have realized, oh, but they are like any other party. Once you are judged like any other party, they will be equally harsh in punishing you like they punish any other party. And I think that's where the big damage has happened.
Yes. We have Tanvi standing by right now with the poll of polls. And this is important. And it will be interesting to look at where all of the polls have landed and what that difference is between them. And I'll go to Mr. Ratan Manilal and, of course, to T.R. Ramchandran to comment on the poll of polls as we put it up. Tanvi?
Yes, so because it helps put things in perspective, like you also said, while we have given out the numbers and the projections that Times Now and VMR have put together, just to give you a sense of how, where and what direction is everybody headed, we thought we'll collate some of these other exit polls that have already come out and show it to you. So this is ours. This is the Times Now VMR number, which projects 306 for NDA, 132 for UPA, and 104 for others. See Voter is the other big one that is usually referred to by multiple channels. 287, that's the number they're giving for an NDA, and they're giving a slightly lower number to UPA as well, and a higher number to others, 127. So that's a difference of about 22 seats over there. Jan Ki Baat is broadly on the same line as us. So Jan Ki Baat exit poll is giving 305 to the NDA, 124, much lower than what we've estimated to the UPA. And so there's a bit of a gain here for the others in comparison to what we are showing. And then there is News Nation. They've actually only given a range. Most of these have a range, but we've picked up the median because that's what the exit poll the researchers as well as channels are going with. News Nation, though, is sticking to the range of 282 to 290 and 118 to 126 for the UPA. We're tracking a couple of more, but those exit polls are still building up. They've not come out with the final number. They're going state by state, so we'll add those. But if you see, largely, the consensus is that NDA is making it past the halfway mark. BJP by itself may not do it, but with the help of its allies, it should be comfortably on the other side of the halfway mark. Faye?
All right, Tanvi.
There is just one poll. Now, if all the list that Tanvi read out and the others, which it's not on our screen yet, but there's only just one poll which is actually majorly disagreeing with all the others. Most of the others are in one direction, and that is AC Nielsen and ABP. The AC Nielsen poll suggests that the NDA will stop at 267. So this is the only poll that is putting the NDA in a minority.
Yes.
The NDA, not the BJP. The BJP is even lesser for them.
Yes. So that's an interesting poll. We're waiting for those all of those numbers to come in, and our team's looking at it and putting it together. But I'll go to Mr. Ratan Manilal. Mr. Lal, obviously, there was an argument that was placed before the panel earlier that, and all of the opposition saying disregard these numbers. This is sold out media that's putting it out to perhaps change opinions. But given where the poll of polls is, and if you would please explain to our audience the significance of a poll of polls, and we'll add more data to this as it comes to us. But what do you think now, given where the poll of poll is?
See, I think as far as these agencies working is concerned, they have a field staff, you know, their correspondents or whatever you call them, and they are spread all over the state, and they must have some kind of a methodology to work with. So I believe the agency which has the most extensive network in across states in UP and other big states will perhaps come back with a result which is more likely to be close to what has actually happened. And the agencies which are confined to working in cities or, you know, small towns or highway towns and so on, they will perhaps give a result which is quite starkly different from the other agencies. So I think all the agencies which are listed here on your screen must be having their areas of influence and their areas of experience across states. Like some agency must be having a vast network in the north, some in the west, and so on. So I think that reflects in the numbers. And as I have seen in the last previous 3-4 elections also, there are some agencies which have proved to be quite close to the actual result in, say, North India or UP and Bihar, for example. We all remember what the exit polls forecast for the Bihar election result and what it actually turned out to be. So I think there is an element of experience and element of the actual outreach the team has with voters who are coming out from the polling station, and the kind of connectivity they have with the local people also, because exit polls not always manage to talk to the actual voter, but they talk to many other people also. So I think by and large, I will tend to agree with the poll of polls, because these were the numbers which we had been discussing here in Lucknow and across Uttar Pradesh, because we all felt that the numbers for the BJP will obviously declined from what the party has registered in 2014. It was the all-time high, like 73 out of 80. So I think the Gathbandhan of SP and BSP has done well for itself in reviving the caste-based political combinations that have always been so prevalent across UP, and which were obliterated by the BJP's appeal, or let us say Modi's appeal in 2014. So now perhaps, combined to a slight fall in Modi's appeal,
yes,
the performance of the Yogi government in Uttar Pradesh have led to that figure in UP, which has led to, a reduction in the NDA numbers at an all-India level.
Okay. Thank you, Mr. Lal. I just want to come back to the studio panel about the poll of polls. Vinay, so if you could help our audience understand, now we've just added ABB Nielsen to the number as well. and we'll get Tanvi out to take a look at it. But if we just put that back, please, put Nielsen back on the screen, and we'll see that there's one poll, like Vinay was pointing out, that's actually going in the opposite direction. There it is. It's the third one on your screen, ABP Nielsen. It shows... Should we hold on to that for a second? So it shows that the NDA is at a 265. So the BJP by itself would be far lower than that. And but there is only one. There it is, 267 for the NDA, 127 for the BJP. It's putting the others in a far stronger position.
Yeah.
So how much stock would you place in that one poll?
Well, look, we've had instances in the past where one poll which has disagreed and differed from everyone else has turned out to be the one which is right. Well, whether it's going to happen this time or not. Like, for instance, in 2014, there was one particular pollster that actually predicted a fair amount of landslide for the BJP, which is what actually happened. Most of the other polls underestimated the BJP.
Yes.
There was just only one which predicted right. In this case, this is the only poll that is putting the NDA in a minority. Everyone else is putting the NDA in a majority, even if it's a thin majority. Like, Sea Voter is saying 287, which is a thin majority for the alliance. But everyone else is putting in a majority. This is the only one that believes that that the NDA itself will be in a minority. So whether it's an outlier or whether it's just got its sampling wrong.
Yes. Mr. Rath, when you look at all of these numbers, do you see the NDA settling closer to 300? Or is this enough evidence to believe that it will settle closer to 300?
I think NDA will go past the 300 mark now. I don't see any reason why it should be within 300. It would go somewhere between 305 and 310.
Yes. In fact, the Nielsen numbers were the only numbers that were slightly kinder to the Mahagathbandhan in Uttar Pradesh.
I was about to say this. Look, in a poll of like this, in an exit poll in a national election, agency has to get only one large state wrong to have your figures completely off the mark. Yes. It's pretty much that.
So you would get most
of the states right.
It's possible that Nielsen got Uttar Pradesh wrong.
Either they got one wrong or some of the other, the ones who are not agreeing with Nielsen have got some other large state wrong. But usually it's just one state that makes all the difference.
Okay, now I'm just actually going to read all of this out because it's starting to become entertaining. Omar Abdullah, an hour ago, said every single exit poll can't be wrong, so it's time to switch off the TV, log out of social media, and wait to see if the world is still spinning on its axis on the 20th.
Okay, so I got a sense of humor. Omar Abdullah is a repeat offender in the sense of humor department. In 2014, he actually tweeted saying, "Let's pack our bags and come back only in 2023."
Yeah.
He said so
as well. Yes, yes, yes.
So either he has a wicked sense of humor or he's fortune telling, and it's turning out to be true. So we also have Sharvendra Singh of the Samajwadi Party who joins us right now out of Delhi along with the rest of our guests. Mr. Singh, thank you for joining us. Not a great picture for the SP-BSP Gathbandhan. What is the response from inside the party right now? Are you also going to say that these exit polls are not to be trusted? What did your internal mathematics or calculation tell you your number was going to be at?
Well, I think largely, you know, we have a largely varying picture of how much we're actually going to get. I mean, I was actually switching channels, and I think the average that the Mahagathbandhan should be getting is about 40, according to your poll of polls, if you talk only about Uttar Pradesh. But then there's also this poll that of I think ABP, if I'm not wrong, that actually says 56. So I would like to be on that positive side, and we were actually expecting about 55. To be very honest, that's my assessment of how much we should be getting.
Any of you want to ask him
questions? Yes, I do.
But then you also have channels that are showing 20 and 17 and 19, which is not believable at all for us. I mean, honestly speaking, that is not. I'm not going to buy that.
Let's for a minute forget all the exit polls being wrong or right. I have a simple direct question to you. Would you today, at least today, now that the polling is over, you don't have to bother about rhetorics, it's not going to impact the voting. My simple question to you is, would you today accept that the Congress has dealt you a very harsh blow? They've just made your life difficult. They should have been part of your alliance. Would you not blame them for it?
Well, look, I think the Congress did what they had to do, and whether they dealt us a harsh blow or otherwise, maybe they just dealt BJP a very bad blow. That is to be seen only on the 23rd. we can't say, because you know that there are many seats on which they say that the Congress has actually ended up helping us, and there are many seats in which they said that they've ended up helping the BJP.
The reason I asked you this question is because your party leader Akhilesh Yadav, who's a young leader, has now technically been singed twice by the Congress. I mean, he had a much the same experience in 2017 when your party did very badly because of the alliance, and now you have a repeat now in Lok Sabha where you again don't seem to be doing well with Congress now playing the opposite game.
Well, how can you say that there's, you know, that there's a repeat? You know, we're still to wait for the actual numbers which are coming on the 23rd, the exit polls and all the eventual results, right?
Mr. Chaturvedi, assuming the polls are right, then
I think I'll be in a better position to answer this question on the 23rd. Okay. Because I am quite honestly, I'm very convinced that most of these polls, at least as far as the state of Uttar Pradesh go, are wrong. So I would, my number, my personal number and my party's number would be minimum 55 for the Gathbandhan. And another maybe 4 or 5 for the Congress.
That's interesting.
I think the BJP gets about 30, 35.
Mr. Singh, first of all, there's someone at your door. Secondly, how can all of your polls, all of the polls be wrong? But Mr. Bharat Kumar Radwa has a question.
Mr. Singh, I have one question to ask you. Do you think that since you broke away with the Congress, and otherwise, Mayawati, you and Congress, if had contested together, picture would have been totally different. And do you feel that Congress, in actual run, played for BJP and not for you?
I think I answered that question, in the previous, the last time around, where I said that there are actually many seats where we think that the Congress might have dealt us a bad blow. For example, Saranpur, I think had the Congress not fielded a candidate, to be honest, I think the Gathbandhan candidate would have had a clean sweep. But then having said that, I mean, a couple of polls are also showing that Saranpur is still going to the Gathbandhan. So whether the Congress has actually, actually given us a bad deal or whatever is still to be seen for the 23rd.
You're not ruling it out.
With or without the Congress, I'm still quite convinced that we will get around 55 seats, and I'm only talking about the Gathbandhan. I'm not talking about the Congress. Congress should get about 4 or 5, I would say again. I keep repeating it all the time, but I have nothing else to say because the only thing I can really say is that we can only wait till the 23rd.
No, your party leader, because, your Akhilesh Yadav has been very large-hearted to the Congress, but Congress has been fairly petty with you, isn't it?
In fact, Anurag ji had a question as well.
Yeah, Shivendra, I would like to ask one question.
I think.
Just one second, Mr. Singh. Yes.
Yeah. Yeah. What do you think about the role of Mayawati ji? How she was good with you, or she created more problems for your party? Or the vote transfer, especially the Yadav vote being transferred to her or not?
Look, I think this whole perception that's been built by the media that the Yadav's vote, that the Yadav votes or the SP votes as such don't get transferred to the BSP, I think is a total myth. That is not something that's actually playing out on the ground. And I'll tell you something. This perception that this decision of the alliance was only taken by two leaders is not true. This is only built by the media and the BJP. There was a groundswell of opinion that actually came out where the Karyakartas of the Bahujan Samaj Party and the Samajwadi Party were convinced that the two parties should actually fight together. And then you had another party, the RLD, which came into the fold and formed the alliance. And let's not forget that the BSP and the SP have basically are two parties which have both been formed on social movements. So the the basic ideology of both the parties is actually quite same. So I think that the BSP and the SP and the vote transfer between the two parties has worked rather beautifully on the ground.
All right, I just want to bring in Mr. T.R. Ramchandran, who's a senior journalist joining us out of the Noida studio. Mr. Ramchandran, do these numbers surprise you? They seem to be taking all the opposition parties completely by shock and surprise at this point. But are you surprised by the numbers?
No, I am not the least bit surprised. I think a result of this kind was staring everyone in the face. But the only thing is, the opposition didn't want to accept the reality as it existed from day one. I don't think they had much of a fight against BJP. And just one individual in the BJP, Mr. Narendra Modi, he swung the votes in their favor in 2014. He's done a similar job again this time, but maybe not to the same extent as in 2014. He has only lost out very marginally, but the vote has gone to a single individual, and that is Mr. Narendra Modi. And if he has triumphed, I think he has reason to be gleeful about the manner in which he's gone about doing his job, currying, you know, getting votes for his party. You remove him from this whole picture, I wonder what BJP would be like. Nevertheless, I think the results, the final results on 23rd plus minus 5% would be somewhere around these lines. So the BJP has every reason to be gleeful and happy that they've got a second term on the trot, which has not happened in the past. For all the shining India that happened in 2004, when Mr. Vajpayee's government was considered to be good, and a lot of people had hopes that Mr. Vajpayee will get a second consecutive term, you know, the BJP went crashing. So that's how it is in politics. I'm not the least bit surprised what has happened this time, because I think it's a vote which has gone to a single individual who held the helm and steered the party extremely well, both in 2014 and again 5 years later in 2019. The credit entirely should go to this one individual. I don't think there is a second leader in BJP who can come anywhere near Mr. Narendra Modi in garnering votes. And there ends the story.
All right. Very well said. And we have Tanvi back again. And Tanvi's come back this time to take us through the main states of Uttar Pradesh and the states surrounding the entire, what we call, the Hindi heartland. Tanvi?
Tanvi is sulking a little bit, Faye, because her thunder has been stolen since so much of Uttar Pradesh conversation has happened without me actually revealing the numbers on the video wall. But let's bring up the numbers now and just break it up for you as well between various parties. And we're going to start with Madhya Pradesh. And in Madhya Pradesh, the headline here is that Congress has failed to make a dent. So irrespective of what we saw in the state assembly elections, what we have seen is that the BJP has managed to hold on to the kind of numbers they saw in 2014. From 27, they've just about come down to 24. Five seats for the Congress party, so that's a gain of about three seats and nothing for Mayawati in the state of Madhya Pradesh. So there was a lot of conversation of whether or not we'll see Congress gain a little bit after the state election results in both Rajasthan and Madhya Pradesh. And you can see it's just about a three-seat gain here and a few seats in Rajasthan. BJP, on a central level, has managed to use the Modi effect to get seats out of Madhya Pradesh and Rajasthan. Let's go on to Uttar Pradesh and bring you the picture there. We've had conversations about it. Can it or can it not stop the Modi juggernaut, and it looks like Modi has managed to limit the Gathbandhan's charge. So yes, while they were pretty much wiped out, especially Mayawati in 2014, together these two are projected to cobble up about 27 seats from about five seats that they got in 2014. But if you look at it, BJP is still managing to get about 49 seats in 2019. That's the projection versus 73. So yes, it has come down, but you know, many were actually expecting Gathbandhan to get a lot more. So this is the number that's looking like right now. And of course, two seats for Congress, no prizes for guessing which these two seats are. I'm going to move on to the state of Bihar and quickly get you those numbers. And there also, between the BJP and the JDU, the picture is looking good for the NDA alliance. So 30 seats in 2019 for the NDA alliance. The breakup here really is 16 for the BJP and 14 for the JDU. And between Congress and RJD, they will probably get about 10, of which I think three are going to the Congress, and seven of these seats are actually going to. So the numbers haven't changed much here. Of course, this time it's Nitish and BJP who are together, which is why you're looking at this comparison. Back to you.
Thank you, Tanvi. That is an interesting question. Which two seats do you think the Congress has won in Uttar Pradesh?
Which two seats? Anybody's guess?
The Gandhi family.
Well, well, the Gandhi family. Well, if that if, they haven't won Amethi, then they're really, I mean, Mr. Gandhi is going to have to consider another profession, because there's really no point in this any longer.
Absolutely. Or move permanently to Kerala.
Or move to Wayanad. Yes. Or move to Wayanad. Wayanad is gorgeous, though.
There's or to Kedarnath.
It's cold in Kedarnath.
But it seems to be obvious that it would be Raibareli and Amethi.
Yes. But you know, that's actually that should cause a fair amount of concern to the Congress party if all they have won in Uttar Pradesh is Raebareli and Amethi.
Look, can I be very honest with you? They would be the only ones who will express surprise over it, to be honest. Mm. I think all through seven phases, they've been saying this, that the Congress's strategy in UP is befuddling. Yes. Mm. Nobody has a clue what they intend doing. When they claim that they're not part of the Gathbandhan, they've put up candidates to damage the BJP and the upper caste vote may get split. I mean, I don't know which dream world they live in.
Yeah. We can ask. Rohan Gupta of the Congress is with us right now. Rohan Gupta, is Rohan with us? Can he hear us? Yes. Rohan Gupta, what happened?
And before
you say that all the exit polls are wrong, I just want to point out that they can't all be wrong. But if we just look at Uttar Pradesh, which is what we're looking at right now, two seats out of the entire state, that should be a deep blow to the Congress party.
See, first of all, I was listening to your debate, and if you see the numbers, right, I'm not saying whether poll is right or wrong. If you are saying that all polls cannot be wrong, I'm just giving a single number. One channel gives 65 to BJP in UP. Another channel gives 20 to BJP in UP. Variation of 40 seats. If you put all the channels together and all the seats together, the margin is such a high that the government will change. So that's what I'm saying. If assuming, I'm not going by the total number. If you see state to state thing, I have just analyzed 14 states, the results are different in one poll and the results are different in the poll. So my point is, if you analyze the polls and if you analyze the sample size, average sample size in all the polls is not more than 2 to 3 lakh. And what you are evaluating is 100 crore vote. And even in poll to poll, you have variation of 50 seats. In a state like UP, one channel is giving 65, other channel is giving 20. How can you come to any judgment? So I'm just keeping my fingers
internal
crossed.
Internal calculation.
And let us see.
What's your
UP,
internal
how
calculation,
many seats
Rohan
get.
Gupta?
The numbers will be there on 23rd.
No, you must have some internal calculations.
Minimum internal calculations. Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. We are not getting less than 130, 135.
Uttar Pradesh.
This is our minimum calculation. Uttar Pradesh, we are getting minimum around 10 to 11 seats. On our own.
On your own. Anyone has questions for him?
Oh, well, I mean, yeah. Look, I think with the kind
there
of
are
figure
three,
that...
There are three...
2 to 11 jump
there are three exit polls which have shown... There are three exit polls which have shown 6 to 7 seats to Congress in UP.
But you're expecting even more than
there
that.
There are four exit polls in Tamil Nadu. They have shown 13 to DMK. And there are five exit polls which have shown 36 to DMK.
What's your
this
point?
This is the variation
so
in the
basically,
number.
The opposition is going out today dishing all exit
My
polls.
My point is looking at exit polls. Yeah. But where you are going to win in
I'm just
UP.
Saying that. What I'm saying is, assuming that, that's what I'm saying.
Yes.
I'm assuming that for a moment, the exit polls are right. You are saying the total number is 306. But if you see the variation in existing exit poll to exit poll, how can you trust the numbers? Assuming that one number is extreme right in one exit poll, the other number is right of
not
other exit poll.
All right. So I just want to point out to our audience and to my panel that this number that you see on your screen right now is the latest updated number from Uttar Pradesh. Uttar Pradesh voted in today's phase as well. So this is the latest updated number. It's taking now the BJP plus up to 56.
Yeah.
And that's quite that's important and that's to note as well.
Look, Mr. Gupta.
AC Nielsen number is 20.
Okay.
AC Nielsen number is 20.
So you are picking the outlier. That's convenient.
That's
yes.
What yeah, look, I mean, I wish, Mr. Gupta, you will say exactly the same thing if we put up the numbers for Punjab, because in Punjab, Amrinder is doing very, very well. Look, let's stop. This is way too old a game for you to diss it.
This is
a very old game. Dissing exit polls by a losing party is an old game. I have a different question. No,
just
I have a very different point to make. Listen. Can anyone in the Congress explain to me now that the voting is over?
I'm not saying that exit polls are right or wrong.
Can anyone in the Congress explain to me now that the polls are over, what exactly was Congress's strategy in Uttar Pradesh? What were you trying to achieve in that state? I'm befuddled. I've seen like seven phases and I still don't know.
See, our strategy was, our strategy was very clear. We wanted to energize our cadre. Whatever seats we fought, at least 25 to 30 seats were there. We were serious contenders. And when the results will come, at least at the end of the day, we will energize our cadre and we will prepare for the assembly elections.
Sir, the senior...
he's accepting that their eye was on the assembly elections and rebuilding the cadre for the future rather than this particular
party. You don't build a party by losing an election. You build a party by winning an election.
No, but at the end of the day, Mr. Rohan Gupta, if this is the tally you're walking away with, which is two out of all of the seats in Uttar Pradesh, two out of 80 is abysmal. Really, what cadre, what future are you really looking forward to have at this rate? Sudhanshu Mittal of the BJP is with us. Let me just bring in Mr. Mittal. Mr. Mittal?
I can challenge on 23rd.
Okay, we'll we'll see the challenge on 23rd. Fair enough. Mr. Mittal, what do you think worked in BJP? Did the SP, BSP and the Congress cut each other out or cancel each other out in all of the seats that they contended because they split the vote?
You see, the chemistry has bulldozed the arithmetic of elections. Because what you are concluding in terms of split vote for UP, then the results, what you are seeing in the other parts of the country would not have been the same. There was an undercurrent which was strong for Mr. Modi. And before, the challenge to this undercurrent was the arithmetic of elections, which was attempted in UP. But the people of UP have decided to just demolish the arithmetic of caste and go with the national mainstream of the chemistry this nation needs for its glory. I just want to make a few points. There is a qualitative difference which this election indicates. Earlier, center was an aggregation of state politics. Now, people are not voting for the state assemblies. They are voting for the nation. They are voting for the parliament. And this is a phenomenal change in the polity of this country. You see, when we say chunav, what is chunav? Chunna. Aap vikalpon ke beech mein chunte. You make choices out of alternatives. And the choices were so obvious. And that is the reason why you see this resounding prediction which you are giving. Yes, Mr. Gupta would like this, like us to believe that this is not true. That's fine. I'm sure they have thought about an explanation that if on 23rd, what you are showing is the truth, they will say the EVMs have shown their, the true colors. So these are all explanations. The fact
remains
that this nation reposes its faith on Modi.
No, yeah, point please. Here is not of explanation. I have a simple question. How would you justify the variation of number of seats in UP? One poll is saying 68, other poll is saying 20. I have a simple question. I am not disowning anything. Neither I am saying that figures are right or
Gupta,
wrong. As a normal citizen of India, my question is very simple.
Mr. Gupta,
if in a one state you have variation of 50 seats,
Mr. Gupta,
how can you trust the poll? That's
can all. I answer? Can I, Mr. Gupta?
Please.
The trends of every poll at the end of the day is universal, which is BJP is sweeping the poll. Now,
no,
if it is
no,
10
that's,
seats
that's
here,
not,
10
right,
seats
right, one
there.
Second. I'm going to break this up because
can
if I allow the Congress and the BJP to have a conversation, you will take up the rest of the show. But I just want to open this up to the panel if anybody has questions for you. Pacha Sen has a question for the BJP.
Sudhanshu, I have a question. I'm waiting on the 23rd if all this is right. Where are you going to send the laddus? I'm in Bombay. In 2014, you sent the laddus to the studio. Are you going to send us laddus on the 23rd? That's a simple question. Please do answer it.
I'll make sure that somebody is waiting outside the studio to ensure that you get the laddus. Because given the relationship we have, you must be the first one who should get all those laddus.
I'm worried about this relationship.
That Mr. Fadnavis has dug up the whole road outside our studio. So just advise the guy, right? The whole road is dug up.
At least
you have to take the rear exit.
The guy who will have those laddus would be competent enough to reach your office.
Yes. Okay.
No, but I think the smile on Sudhanshu Mittal's face.
One more point.
Yes. Okay. Yes. Go ahead, Mr. Mittal.
Sorry.
Yeah. One more observation I just wanted to make. You see, this election on the opposition side was sought to be made into a referendum of we hate Modi and we are together. So the nation is with us. Mm. The other side was this nation needs a leadership like Modi because the challenges before the nation need to be addressed. And the alternatives are such that the nation must make a choice. In this election, two things have happened simultaneously. As I said, one, a decisive leadership is what people have voted for. You know, there's a saying, for leadership, netritv ke liye, you must have a dream in your eye and fire in your belly. Now, on a comparative note, people did not believe that there was fire on the other side because they didn't have a face. On this side, the sincerity and the competence and the commitment to the nation was well appreciated and believed. And that is why people have decided to go all along with Mr. Modi. This is very critical because, as I said, let us look at Madhya Pradesh, let us look at Rajasthan.
We can't ask any more questions because we've run out of time in this hour. Mr. Mittal, I understand what you're saying and we will continue this conversation. But we have to take a very quick break now and we'll come back and take a look at the numbers. We also have to look at other interesting states on the other side. For example, West Bengal, the big battle. We'll take a look at it on the other side of this break. Don't go anywhere.
Hang on, Johnny. There's one more.
What happens when a meerkat tries to inspire a Kia designer?
Oh.
Nothing.
Johnny?
Hettich Fittings. Make your furniture work beautifully. German quality you can trust.
MRF ZLX. Comfort made more comfortable.
Are you looking for this? Now, Mr. Forgetful, don't forget. Plywood with Okume Veneer.
Okume Veneer. Hi, I need veneer from Oshimi. It's smooth, has a beautiful finish.
That can only be plywood from Okume Veneer from Gabon, Africa.
That's the one.
Looking for long-lasting, beautiful finish and environment-friendly plywood? Ask for plywood made by companies using only Okume Face Veneer from Africa.
Revive, recharge, rejuvenate. Rainjoy Plus by Ortiz.
हम पहले दिन से ही चुनाव प्रचार के दौरान कहे थे आपसे और सभी से कि एनडीए की बढ़त होगी और नरेंद्र मोदी पुनः प्रधानमंत्री बने. विपक्ष के पास एक तो एकता नहीं थी. दो फ्रंट पहले दिन से काम कर रहे थे, एक कांग्रेस के नेतृत्व वाला और एक जो है फेडरल फ्रंट का. कभी भी एकता दिखाई नहीं दी, जबकि एनडीए पहले से ही सीटें भी डिक्लेयर कर चुका था और एकता का प्रदर्शन भी.